could come and go as I pleased. Dog could visit.
No.
Oh, you know, Mr. Fawkner, last time I was out, I was really frightened. I didn't know anybody, and nobody wanted to know me. But this time...
Well, what do you think?
Bloody ripper.
That land deal that I told you about?
The one you stole 7,000 for?
It's a big one.
How big?
600% profit in a couple of weeks.
Go on.
Well, with that kind of money coming in, why should I burn down the factory to hide the theft? I mean, I could have paid the money back with interest.
Get your bloody paws off me, Bert!
What the hell's going on in here? Turn this stuff down! Get out! What are you talking about? You just pack up all your stuff and clean up this goddamn mess and get out of here. And you shut up, too, or you'll end up out of here as well. Oh, come on, move it, you fools!
Clean up.
You're damn right you'll clean up. What the hell were you on about, Maxine?
He was just having a party. Got a bit out of hand, I guess.
You guess? The counselor could close this place down now. Do you realize that?
You're gonna throw me out?
I'm thinking about it.
Jeez, oh, Jude, I'm real sorry, honest. We just got a bit carried away, you know. I'll tell you what, I'll get the guys to come round.
I don't want those guys within spitting distance of this place. Do you understand me?
Oh, but they...
Now, look, Maxine, just don't push your luck. It's taken me a very long time to get this place running, and I still need council approval to run it. And I'm not going to have a stupid little bitch like you come in here and ruin it for everybody else. Now, if you want to have your parties, you go ahead. You have them. But you piss off and have them somewhere else.
I'm just fine. I'm locked up for something I didn't do, and I've just handed you the key. That makes me feel just great.
I heard about your interview with the police.
I bet you did.
It's unusual for a prisoner to make a statement like that. They're more likely to insist they're completely innocent.
I am innocent. Do I look like a murderer to you? That poor old guy. How can anyone believe that I was responsible for his death?
You took the money.
I've done that before. I've borrowed the money a few times before, but I always put it back. Well, nobody even knew it was gone. Why would I suddenly want to burn the place down and get police and newspapers and God knows who else poking around asking questions?
It doesn't make much sense, does it?
Do you believe me?
Yeah, I do, for what it's worth.
That's something, anyway.
You'd better get changed. Lights out soon. Good night.
Night.
What the hell are you doing?
Nothing.
Would you mind sitting still while you're doing it?
What difference does it make to you what I do?
Plenty. I'd like to finish this chapter. You're giving me the jitters. Oh, God.
Look, just because everyone says you're the boss, you reckon you can push people around. Well, don't try it with me, okay?
Do you think you're real tough, don't you?
Don't you?
No, I don't. Listen, why don't you make some more cocoa? The water will still be hot.
Make your own bloody cocoa.
Please? What's your real name, anyway? It's Patricia.
Everyone calls me Paddy.
Fair enough. What do you do for a crust?
I'm a prisoner.
Before you came in here, smart ass.
I was a courier. It was good. Better than most city jobs.
Uh-huh. A country girl.
What's wrong with that?
Nothing. Hey, Paddy.
Hmm?
Do you know Doreen Burns?
Who?
No, I didn't think you did. Been trying to figure something out.
What?
Well, coming in here and giving the screws a serve is understandable. Not too bright, but understandable. But what about your mate, Barbara?
She's no mate of mine. Never seen her before in my life.
What did you stuck into her for then? Well, come on, what did she do? Well, you don't just thump someone for no reason.
Why are you always asking questions? It's none of your business, so butt out.
Okay. Oh, hell.
What's happened?
Nothing. It's just 10 o'clock, that's all.
Oh. Nothing. Just wanted to make sure you were still there.
Don't worry, I'm not going anywhere.
Finished cleaning, eh? Not bad. Not bad at all. How's your head?
Fine. Hey, I got some real coffee. You want some?
Yeah, it smells great. Listen, don't you even have a hangover?
No, I don't get hangovers.
Well, the least you can do is suffer, you know.
Here, try this.
Hey, this is good coffee. Where'd you learn to make coffee like this?
On the road.
With the bikies?
Yeah. See, we used to camp out a lot. On the beach or anywhere. And we used to make coffee in them Turkish coffee pots, you know, the ones with the long handle.
Yeah, laced with rum, I'll bet.
Laced with whatever. You going out?
Yeah, I gotta see Mrs. Davidson.
About the council.
And other things.
Geez, dear, do you reckon that bloke's gonna give us a hard time?
Well, I don't know, do I? I've talked to him, but he wasn't impressed.
Oh, gee, Jude, I'm real sorry. I'll make it up to you.
All I want you to do is just stay out of trouble, okay?
Well, I've been thinking about what you said, about not being a selfish bitch and all, and I thought, well, maybe you let me help out in the shop sometimes. I've got a few ideas.
Hey, we have to have a license first. Now, that's something else you forgot yesterday, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, it's not our fault if they just walk in off the street.
I know. We certainly need the bread, don't we?
Yeah, that's what I thought.
Anyway, I gotta go. I'll talk to you later, okay?
Sure.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Oh, Maxine. No grog. And no funny cigarettes.
Scout's on it, Jude. Ah, long night?
Oh, not too bad. Lawson's quieting down now she's in with Smith.
Good.
The other one, Fields, he's a bit upset, though.
Huh?
They're throwing the book at her and she claims she's innocent.
I'm not surprised. They all say that.
Yeah, this one's different, though.
She's pretty.
She admits she took the money. If there hadn't been a fire, she'd never been caught. So why would she commit arson and murder? Just doesn't make sense.
Did she tell you all this?
Yeah.
Watch it, Steve.
It's not like that. We have had some lunch tomorrow.
Yes, fine. Thank you.
Hi, Jude. How's it going?
Oh, fine, thanks.
Really fine?
Bloody awful, if you'll excuse my French.
Why?
Oh, I don't know. Suddenly I'm a landlady, an accountant, and council's running me around by the bloody nose. And after last night...
Well, what happened last night?
Oh, Maxine and her bikey friends decided to have a party. Mr. What's-it from the council walked in the middle of it.
Oh, no.
You can guess what he said. Oh, stupid girl.
Yeah, she's that okay. Still, she's a nice kid. Just a bit crazy.
You wouldn't have this in blue, would you?
Sorry.
You sure? Maybe you got some out the back.
I don't think so.
Gee, I'd be real grateful if you could check it for me.
I'm sure we haven't.
Pity, because I've been looking for a blue one of these for ages and me mum's driving me silly.
I'll have a look.
Last night, then?
She's not as tough as she makes out.
Oh, I wouldn't count on that if I was you.
She's not going to push me round. I told her, straight to her face.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
She's going to have you eating out of her hand in a week.
Nobody pushes me round.
Hey, Patty, take this over to maternity, will you?
Why?
Because you are the only one free at the moment.
Chrissie?
Yeah?
There's a hand over here, will you?
Where do I go?
Don't tempt me. Just ask the screw on the gate. She'll show you the way.
So what were you chatting about?
Oh, you know, just things. Actually, I was giving her a bit of advice.
Ha!
What's wrong with that?
The last thing she needs is advice from you. She's aggro enough as she is.
Blimey, a person only has to open her mouth.
Yeah, well, when it's your mouth, it's always bloody trouble.
Blimey. What are you doing here?
Well, I just wanted to say I was sorry about what happened yesterday. I didn't even know it was you. No, honest, I didn't. Went kind of crazy when the door opened.
Guess I just don't like being locked up.
What's the matter with you?
Nothing. Look, I accept your apology, okay? As far as I'm concerned, nothing happened. Now, if you'll just leave me alone...
You're talking as if I'm some kind of nutcase.
No, I'm not.
You are too. You think I'm nuts, don't you?
I didn't say that.
Well, that's what you bloody well meant. Give us a fag.
Over there on the table.
I might take the whole pack.
Oh, sure, go ahead. I've got more.
Judy!
Judy?
Well, that was a waste of time.
Why, what'd she say?
Oh, she thought it was a terrific idea getting in professional help. But the department, they said that I couldn't do a thing until I'm officially open. I might do it anyway.
Well, how you pay them?
God knows. But I gotta do something. I mean, I need someone there to cope when I'm not there. I wish B was out.
Oh, that's an interesting thought.
Yes, isn't it? Can't you just see her with the council?
Yeah, and the bikies.
I'd just be able to sit back and let her do all the work, oh. Eh? I'll see you later, huh?
All right, then. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, look who's chatting up the new girl.
Jealous, Chrissie?
Me? I wouldn't touch him with a barge pole, not after what he'd done to Lizzie.
Promises, promises.
Who's Lizzie?
Oh, nice old duck nearly died. Because Stevie Wonder over there didn't have the guts to stand up to Ferguson. Hey, Wonder Boy. How's Lizzie getting on in hospital?
When I visited her yesterday, she was okay. She sends a love to you all. She'll be back here sooner than we thought.
Oh, I bet she's thrilled about that.
She is, actually. Lizzie's applying for parole, and I think she's got a pretty good chance of getting it.
Hey, that's great!
Great. Everyone's getting out except me.
Well, I'm not.
Don't remind me. I'm depressed enough already.
Oh, blimey. What's got into you today, anyway? Don't you want Lizzie to get parole?
Of course I do, you stupid cow. Yeah, sure, Mr. Morris.
There's no need for you to all stop working. Come on, we'll talk outside.
Lizzie's coming back tomorrow.
Cool, that's a bit soon, isn't it?
Yes, I would have thought so, but the doctors have cleared her, so she must be all right.
Paul will be glad to get rid of the old bag.
Yes. She'll be pretty weak, though, so Mrs. Davidson wants you to keep an eye on her. She'll be sharing with you.
Yeah, of course. Hey, what does I hear about her applying for parole?
You know about that, do you?
Yeah, a wonder boy told us. Mr. Fawkner. He seems to think she's got a pretty good chance, too.
Yes, it all looks like it. Why don't you apply as well, Beck?
For parole?
Well, your sentence hasn't been reviewed for months now. Why not?
Must be joking.
I can make an appointment for you to see Mrs. Davidson, if you like.
But, well, even if I did, well, I mean, where would I... I haven't got any family left anymore. I mean, what would I do? No.
Oh, sorry, it was just a thought. Of course, if you want to stay here the rest of your life...
Oh, now you are joking.
It's up to you, you know.
Well, you haven't exactly had a lot of experience in this line of work, Mrs. Malone.
I've raised a big family, my dear. 4 boys and 3 girls. Of course, they're scattered all over the country now, but they've all done very well. And I'm very active in the community.
G'day.
Red Cross, CWA, and hospital.
Mrs.
Hillary.
Malone, this is Maxine. She's a resident here.
Pleased to meet you, Maxine.
Likewise, Mrs. M. Bloody dog over the road peed on me bike again. Gonna kick his slats in next time I catch him.
Bright little thing, isn't she? Reminds me of my grandson. And he's a boy, of course.
Of course.
You're mad at me, aren't you?
What do you think? You threw away a chance to make a fortune.
I'm sorry, I had to do it.
You didn't have to do anything.
You don't understand, Philip. I thought if I told them the truth about the money, they'd understand. I couldn't bear to get a long sentence. This place is terrifying. They're crazy in here. You've got to be in here to realize how bad it is. All you hear all day is doors banging. It's as though every door in the world is closing you in. Everybody's scared of something or someone. There's a terrible loneliness, Philip. I'm so frightened.
Rubbish.
It's the truth, Philip. I just can't cope anymore.
You're being ridiculous, Barbara.
Well, I don't know how the other women cope. I suppose they've just got used to it.
Yes, well, if they get used to it, so can you.
What? What's this?
A release form. Ordering me to hand the money you stole over to the police. Sign it.
But why do you need this? Can't you just give it to them?
Oh, don't be stupid. That's tantamount to admitting that I knew the money was stolen.
But you did.
As far as I'm concerned, that money is yours. As your solicitor, I cannot release it without your permission or by order of the court, and we don't want the police going to court over this. Initial here, here, and signature and date at the bottom.
They know you were in on the land deal. I told them.
There's nothing illegal about that. The owner was simply ignorant of the facts. Now, thanks to you and the police, he isn't. He's very bloody rich.
Your name will appear in the papers when I stand for trial.
Not if I can help it.
But you're my solicitor.
I just quit.
But what about Logan?
What about him?
Well, you know he's guilty. You agreed with me. You said you'd investigate him.
I was lying. I just wanted you to keep your trap shut while the deal was going through. If you'd done that, I might have acted for you. Well, there's nothing in it for me now. and I'm not getting involved in a case that's certainly hopeless and probably unprofitable.
You bastard! You bastard! I'll get you! You bastard! How dare you!
You'd better get a shot of something.
Kill him.
I'll see myself out.
He dumped me. Logan framed me.
Who's Logan?
Those bastards.
Oh, you want something to eat?
No, thanks, Jude. I'm in a rush. Hey, what happened to the old duck?
Oh, well, I think she got frightened off.
Hey? Oh, sorry, Jude. Did I say something?
No, love. Look, forget it. She wasn't right for the job anyway.
What job?
I'm getting someone in here to help. Now, so far, we've had Mrs. Malone, who thought that the cure for everything was a good cup of tea and a lie down.
Yeah?
And the next army man, he thought that the only cure were cold showers and push-ups.
Push-ups, eh, beauty?
Oh, will you give it a rest?
I was only joking, boss. There's a trouble with you bloody foreigners. No sense of humour.
I thought you were going out. Where are you going?
Late night shopping. Thought I'd go to the op shops, get a few things, do them up, sell them here.
That's a good idea.
Yeah. Thought you'd like that. See you later.
Bye-bye, honey.
Oh, Chrissie, get out there whinging. It's too early in the morning.
I'm not whinging. I'm just saying that it's our right to have medical attention when we need it.
Yeah, well, if the hospital is unattended, how come I didn't hear about it?
Because you weren't at sick call at muster, were you?
Well, what's wrong with you?
I've got stomach cramps.
She's always got stomach cramps when there's work to be done.
No, I haven't.
You're calling me a liar?
Yeah, well, that's not the point, is it? The point is, what are they going to do if one of us has an accident?
Yeah, what about if someone gets pregnant, eh?
Whoa, I volunteer. Where's a man? Show me a man.
Righto, ladies, I've brought Quinn to help you out this morning. Put she and Lawson on cleaning duties this afternoon, all right?
Yeah, well, you can take over from me here.
Right.
Hey, Mrs. Morris. What's this about the hospital being unattended?
Well, even nurses get sick, Bee.
Who's replacing them?
I don't know yet.
Meaning we haven't got a replacement?
I mean, I don't know. I dare say the department's working on it.
That's not good enough, Mrs. Morris.
Well, it won't hurt some of these women to go without their pills and powders for a day or so.
It's not them I'm worried about. You said yourself, Lizzie's coming back today. What if she has a relapse?
Well, in an emergency like that, we'll call a doctor.
And it'll take all bloody day to get here. No, I don't like it. It's too risky. We've had it happen before.
For your own sake, B, stay out of it, will you? Did you see Mrs. Davidson?
Yeah.
What'd she say?
Oh, she said she passed my request on to the parole board, and I haven't heard anything since, and I don't suppose I will.
You will. But it won't help your chances to be seen stirring up trouble.
Who's stirring? I didn't give the nurses leave without any replacements.
Just remember what I said, will you?
This is a bit off, isn't it? Not having a proper nurse around.
Then what are you going to do about it?
I don't know. I thought you might have an idea.
Well, I haven't.
Shouldn't you have finished work by now?
I had a few reports to finish.
What's this about the new prisoner? I believe she nearly scratched the poor guy's eyes out.
Failed. She got stuck into him, all right.
Yes, but I heard he was her solicitor.
I'd say the relationship went a bit deeper than solicitor-client.
Oh?
As far as I can make out, he told her the case was hopeless and he was going to drop it.
Why?
Apparently she can't afford the fee.
Oh, a very deep relationship.
He's supposed to be checking out a guy called Logan. Feels convinced he's setting her up.
Logan?
I thought I might check him out this afternoon.
I thought you were taking me out to lunch.
I was hoping he'd come with me. It's out in the country. It'd be a nice drive and we could stop off at a little pub for lunch. Good. I'll pick up about 12.
Fine.
Some people have got nothing better to do than go the dunny all day. Well, you gonna say hello, or aren't you?
Lizzie.
Oh, fair go. I'm not as tough as I used to be.
Bloody old liar.
Why are you looking at me like that, as though I'd just come back from the dead?
Well, you weren't too healthy last time I saw you.
Oh, you wouldn't let a little touch of pneumonia get you down. He got a fag.
Lizzie.
Well, I just thought I'd ask. Come on. Tell me what's been going on while I've been away.
Oh, I'll fill you in later. What's been happening with you?
Oh, not very much, I can tell you.
Well, how'd they treat you in hospital?
Not bad. Not very different from here, really. Don't do this, don't do that. Tubes up me nose, tubes everywhere. Wasn't much fun.
Couldn't wait to get back, eh?
Yeah. I could let you into a little secret, though.
Yeah?
Promise you won't tell anybody.
Oh, I don't know, Lizzie. Better not make that sort of promise. Might have to break it.
Eh?
Why don't you just tell me about your parole?
What? How'd you find out about that?
Fawkner told us.
Blabbermouth. It was supposed to be a secret. Oh, don't suppose I could get too mad at him. I mean, it was his idea.
Yeah? I've applied too.
For parole? Hey! Bloody rip.
You think I'll get it?
Oh, God, this business about paying your debt to society's got whiskers on it. I mean, you've been inside longer than anybody I know.
Yeah, except you.
Yeah. Well, if I can get out, so can you.
Oh, it'd be nice, wouldn't it?
Oh, be. It'd be terrific.
What'd you say your name was?
Neil. Neil Murray.
Oh. Nurse Murray.
You were probably expecting a woman.
Yeah, I was. Well, sign there. Wouldn't like to be in your shoes for the next couple of weeks.
Oh? Why?
You'll see. And you better come with me. I'm sure the governor will want to meet you.
Come in.
Nurse Murray to see you, Governor.
Oh, yes, show him in, please, Miss Ferguson. Mr. Murray, I'm Erica Davidson.
How do you do?
Please sit down. That will be all, thank you, Miss Ferguson. I've just been reading through your file. It's very impressive.
Oh, thank you.
You have a particularly wide range of experience. Maternity, psychiatric care. That's very unusual.
No, jack of all trades.
There's nothing here to suggest that your experience is superficial. What made you take up prison work?
Well, I've always been keen on the idea of rehabilitation. See, it seems to me if someone is genuinely sorry for what they've done, then I think they should be given a chance to be able to change their way of life.
And how does nursing fit into this?
Well, nursing is about caring for people. Well, in theory is one thing, but if I can help the women here by giving them the right attention when they need it, then I'll be doing something practical about my theories. Sounds a bit idealistic, I know.
Maybe. Still, I think you'll fit in very well. The women will be at lunch at the moment. Perhaps I ought to introduce you to them. How do you feel about the problem of dealing only with women?
Well, I think I can cope.
I'm sure you will.
This muck. I bet you got better grub in hospital, Lizzie. Chocolate pudding was nice.
Chocolate pudding? We should have told O'Regan that Lizzie was coming back. She might have baked us a cake.
Yeah, tipsy cake. Hey, have we still got some of that booze stashed away anywhere?
No.
Oh, pity. It would have been really mature by now.
Yeah, bloody impossible, you know. That's right up your deathbed, and all we can think about is booze and cigarettes.
Well, you've got to have something to live for.
Hey, B, what's going to happen if Lizzie gets sick again? Who's going to look after her?
Well, what do you mean?
Sister Johnson's got the boot.
What did she do?
She has not got the boot. She's just on extended leave.
We got anyone to take her place?
No, no one yet.
Hey, get a load of that. Yeah.
Hey! All right, ladies, that's enough.
Hey, tell him.
This is Mr. Murray. He will be taking over from Sister Johnson as from tomorrow. And I would appreciate it if you didn't all get sick at once. Thank you.
He's a nurse? He maybe he's a doctor.
They do have male nurses, you know.
Do you mean he's going to examine us?
He can examine me anytime he wants.
We all know you. I would like to see B. Smith in my office after lunch.
Yes, sir.
I noticed Fields wasn't in the dining room. Is she all right?
I think so, just a little upset.
Or perhaps you'd like to see her now.
Oh, yes, of course.
I would say you'd be very busy coming in the morning.
Oh,
Sorry I'm late. A few problems with the car.
Oh, really? So where are you two going to have lunch?
Oh, somewhere up in the country.
We're going to check him on a guy called Logan. Fields reckon he's setting her up.
Barbara Fields? You'll never learn, will you?
Come on, I think we should be going.
And you? Well, you should know much better.
Me? I'm just going along for the ride.
Why shouldn't I tell her what we're doing? It's not against the rules to help out a prisoner.
The trouble is, you always get involved with the pretty ones.
Oh, come on, that's not true.
Well, that's what Colleen thinks anyway.
Who gives a damn about what she thinks? Look, Barbara doesn't mean any more to me than Lizzie does.
Barbara, eh?
Yeah, what's in her name?
She's right, you know.
Who?
Colleen. You'll never learn, will you?
Thanks.
Hi.
Thanking you.
See you tomorrow.
See you.
See you later.
The chairman of the parole board has rejected your application.
I should have known.
For the time being.
Well, that's it then. I may as well go back to work.
I haven't finished yet. Sit down.
Well, what more is there to say?
You owe it to yourself to hear me out. Now sit down. It has been suggested that you reapply in 3 months' time.
Why? So they can knock me back again?
If you can behave yourself for 3 months, you should have no trouble getting your parole.
Oh, I don't believe it.
The chairman has assured me there is hope. Now, your record isn't too bad. The offences are really minor ones. It's just that they keep occurring again and again. To put it bluntly, you're regarded as a troublemaker. Now, if you can behave yourself for 3 months, only 3 months, we can convince the board that you're ready for parole.
That's blackmail.
Some may call it sound strategy. We have known each other for a long time, Bea. Now listen to me. Stop fighting other people's battles. Think about yourself for a change. You shouldn't be in here. You should be outside starting a new life for yourself. I think you're capable of doing it, don't you?
Well, tell that to the parole board.
Well, the way things stand at the moment, I haven't any argument. But give me some ammunition and I won't let you down.
These are the files you asked for.
Oh, thanks.
Problems?
Well, the quantities on the list don't seem to bear any relation to what's in the stock.
It's been pretty hectic around here lately.
Yeah, it's rather obvious. Oh, I noticed you had to replace the doors. What happened?
An inmate, drug addict, went berserk, smashed them with a fire extinguisher.
I see. Does this sort of thing happen often?
No, it doesn't. But then you can't be too careful. Look, most of the women in here, they're addicted to some kind of drug or another. Amphetamines, tranquilizers. And if I were you, keep a very close eye on the surgical alcohol.
I will.
Now, if you want to take any of these home, you're going to have to sign a release form.
Oh, well, I'll read them later when I finish straightening this out.
New broom.
Any objections?
No, none at all. Actually, you could be just what we need around here.
Enjoy your lunch?
Yes, thank you very much.
Well, this all rounded off nicely. It's a good drop.
Thank you. Cheers.
Cheers.
Mmm.
Lovely spot you've got around here.
Yeah, it's very nice.
I know Blakey's got a farm around here somewhere.
What's his name?
Logan.
George Logan? Yeah, I know old George well. Very well. I had a spot of bad luck recently. I suppose you know about that.
The fire, you mean?
Yeah, it was a terrible business. Old George was quite cut up about it. He was in here the night it happened.
Really?
Matter of fact, we had to get the local copper to drive him home.
He was that drunk?
Ah, well, he would have had to got a lift home anyway. He'd put his car in for servicing and there was no other way he could get back to the farm. Oh, excuse me.
What are you two doing? Ah, Quinn. I might have known. Is this a private conversation, or can anyone join in?
Oh, we just thought we'd have a bit of a break. Right, Faye?
Please, miss, we ran out of detergent.
Well, get some more.
We can't, miss. The gate's locked.
That's don't take all day.
Yes, miss.
Please, miss, can I leave the room? Please, miss.
Shut your face. In there. Now, you listen to me. Don't you go giving Ferguson no cheek, because she'll have you for breakfast.
I'm not scared of her.
You must be crazy, then.
I'm not.
Well, you gotta be. Oh, jeez. Oh, must have blown. Door. Oh. Honey, what are you doing? Oh. What the hell's the matter with you? You bloody near killed me,
hey,
you maniac!
Get your paws off her, Quinn. Right, what happened?
She tried to kill
Shut
me.
Shut up. Lawson.
It's dark.
What did Davo say? I'm busting to hear.
Well, she said if I could keep my nose clean for 3 months, I've got a chance.
A chance? Is that all?
A bloody good chance.
Ripper!
Well, 3 months is a long time, Lizzie.
No, it isn't. Your problem is that you're always sticking up for other people. Well, bugger them. Let them do their own dirty work. They'd have to anyway if you weren't there. You think of number one for a change. Well, what's so funny?
Oh, nothing. Just sounds familiar, that's all.
Well, I'm right, aren't I?
Yeah, you're right.
Anyone fancy a game of cards, then?
Not now, thanks, love.
Hey, have you heard the news?
No.
B's gonna be paroled.
What?
Lizzie.
When?
3 months' time. Oh, bull. Well, it's true, isn't it, B?
Not exactly.
Of course it is. All she's got to do is keep out of trouble until then, and we're going to make sure that she does keep out of trouble now, aren't we?
What are you looking at me for?
Cry, cry.
Hey, hold it. Let me at her. I'm going to thump her.
No one thumps anyone around here unless I say so. Now, what's going on?
Well, you know, Big Tough Paddy here. Well, Big Tough Paddy and me's in the storeroom and the light blows and Big Tough Paddy goes bananas.
Why?
Because Big Tough Paddy's afraid of the dark. That's why. You'll find out how tough I am one day.
It's not going to work. We're going to have to put something under the back wheels.
Like what?
Oh, a bit of iron, some branches, anything so I can get a grip on.
Oh, yuck!
Sorry, is that all this thing?
We should have turned back hours ago. I mean, God knows where we are.
I just wanted to talk to him.
What about? I mean, his alibi sticks. He couldn't have possibly got back into the city without a car, let alone been dead drunk.
Well, I just wanted to meet him.
G'day. Can you give us a hand?
Sure. What's the problem? George Logan.
Steve Fawkner.
Hey, you and Patty on cleaning duties again this morning?
Yeah.
Well, behave yourself. No more squabbling out of the pair of you.
Oh, it's only joking.
But did it ever occur to you that it's not so funny being laughed at all the time?
It's her fault. Why does she have to go around being a bully?
Because mean little buggers like you won't give her a chance to be anything else.
All right, I'll get your point. Hey, cop the look on Chrissie's face, would you?
What's up with her?
Well, she wanted to go on sick call and Virgo wouldn't let her. She's spitting chips.
What's the matter with you then? Bloody Faye. Should have dumped her when I had the chance. Well, what's stopping you? What have you heard what B said?
She's only bluffing.
Oh, yeah. You're all right, Charlie, aren't you? She's coming up for parole, isn't she? She ain't gonna risk that on a couple of twits like you two. Is that right?
Well, you're coming along fine, Lizzie. Just make sure you have a nice lot of rest.
Anything you say, Doc?
No, I'm not a doctor. I'm a nurse.
Oh, of course you're a doctor. All those things you told me about myself. How could you know all that if you hadn't been to medical school?
It's all in your file. I read it last night. You've really been through the mill, haven't you?
Have I ever? That's how I know a good doctor, when I see one. You can't fool me.
Well, if it makes you happy, I'll be a doctor.
I knew it. Have you finished with me now, Doc?
For the moment. Oh, unless you need some more pills.
I've got enough pills to last me till Christmas.
Well, just let me know if you need some more,
Righto.
Oh, and Lizzie, I'll have that bottle back, if you don't mind.
What bottle?
This one.
Oh, I wonder how that got there.
Well, I think you might have picked it up by mistake when you collected your cardigan.
Yeah, that's what must have happened.
Well, I'll just put it back where it belongs, okay?
Righto. Oh, and Doc, I reckon you're gonna be all right.
I tell you, it's a crying shame. The only person who's allowed him to see that bit of spunk is Lizzie. Now, I ask you, what good is he going to be to us?
Lizzie's a nurse, Chrissie, not a boy in service.
You can't take me. I'll stick Fee on now.
Not again.
Get away! Get away!
I'm sick of you, Paddy!
You stay out of this. It's between me and her. I never said nothing, be honest.
I thought I warned you to stop throwing your weight around.
Yeah, what are you going to do about it?
You schmuck.
Yeah. What are you going to do about it, Smith?
Nothing.
I understand you've applied for parole, Smith. The next 3 months are going to be very, very interesting.
Oh, GB, that's tough, Ferguson, going on like that.
Oh, don't worry. We'll give her any excuse.
Since when did she need an excuse?
Well, if she tries anything, she'll be sorry. I want that parole, ladies, and nothing is going to stand between it and me. Nothing. I'll speak of the devil.
Quinn!
Shh, I done. Yes, Miss Ferguson?
Outside.
Oh, but I haven't finished my cuppa. See you later.
She's going to be watching you like a hawk.
I'll never watch.
Rather you than me. Hey, where's Lizzie? I want to find out about Dr. Spunk.
She's in the library.
Well, since when has she become a bookworm?
Since he arrived yesterday.
What are you talking about?
She's looking up the medical dictionary from A to Z, trying to find some disease she could be suffering from. She's going to drive him bananas.
What for?
Not for what you'd be after.
Well, then she's wasting her time, isn't she, and is, when it could be much better spent.
Oh, our Lizzie's just after a bit of old-fashioned TLC. Just someone to show a bit of interest.
Yeah, I could do with a bit of that myself.
You want to know something?
What?
So could I.
I thought you had some special duties for me.
And so I have. I want you to start the book up again.
The book? Are you kidding?
Can you think of a better way to find the money you owe me, Quinn?
We won't stand for it, not if you're getting the cut.
You let me worry about Smith.
Oh, I'm the one who's got to live with her.
You're as stupid as you look, Quinn. You don't think for 1 minute that Smith's going to jeopardise her parole now, do you?
No, suppose not. But what about the others? I mean, Bea doesn't have to do anything herself. She just gives a word and no mystery.
Yes, that is a possibility. But then, of course, there's also the possibility that I might jump on it. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah.
You're so worried about Smith and her cronies. Get some protection.
Who?
Lawson. I reckon she could handle herself with that lot.
She mightn't want to do it.
Then it's up to you to persuade her. And I would if I were you, Quinn.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun. Rain are
share.